2017. The last day of 2017. The last day of 2017. I'm here to tell you, it's time to forget some things. It's time to forget. It's time to forget. Now, forgetting doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to actually forget. You're going to remember. Things get in your head, they don't go away. But what he's saying is, don't let the things of your past freeze you in time. Don't let the things that have happened this previous year stop you from what God has for you. Don't let the challenges, the disappointments, the hurts, the angst, don't let all of those things prevent you from accomplishing what God has in front of you. Because so many of us get frozen in time because we stepped out on faith. And if you're to be honest, there are things in your life that you felt God was calling you to do. And you did them. You stepped out. You stepped out on faith. Not only did you step out, you proclaimed it publicly. But then things didn't turn out the way that you thought that they should. 2005, my wife and I, we stepped out and I had this big vision, this big dream to start a movie theater. Never seen anybody do that before. Just, I said, hey, I want to be a business owner. I want to make a whole lot of money. And this is the business that I want to accomplish. I felt like God was allowing us to do that. And I wrote the business plan. You know, Habakkuk, you know, says, write the vision and make a plan. So that he can read it. I always interpreted that as to say, write your business plan. So I did what Habakkuk said. I wrote my business plan and waited for the right opportunity. And then it happened. We had an opportunity to own and operate a movie theater. It was all in the papers. They came and did stories about us. People heard about us. Robin and I were the youngest movie theater owners in the country. We were like 30 years old. We're only one of three black-owned movie theaters in the country, us and Magic Johnson. I like to say that. Me and Magic had something in common. He could buy me, but you know. But we had this great thing, and it was all of big people congratulating us. We'd be walking down, you know, we'd be out and about. People be like, you own that movie theater, right? Good job, man. I'm excited for you. But things didn't turn out the way that we had hoped for them to turn out. So we had visions of us owning many movie theaters around the country. Had this cool name for it. It was called Cinefame. People couldn't pronounce it at first when they saw it, but it just simply combined the name cinema and cafe. We wanted to be the dinner and movie concert that you see all. We were before Studio Movie Grill. We were before the Movie Tavern. We had this dream, and we opened our first one. Then about 18 months later, we had to close the doors. Because we had just enough money to acquire the theater, but nothing else. No working capital. No investors really in place to do that. We had to close the doors, and we were closed for about 8 months, and then we were able to figure some things out. We were able to figure some things up, and we changed our model, and then we reopened again. People celebrate. We're so happy for you. And, you know, we went from the first run of movies to the dollar movies and everything. And people were still excited. And we were back in business. We were moving along. Then about a year later, we just couldn't do it no more. Georgia Power came knocking on the door. About 11 o'clock in the morning. I remember this. 11 o'clock. They said, you have a $12,000 power bill. And we had about $6,000 in the bank account. And I was like, you ain't gonna make me look like a fool. I'm not gonna sit here and have people in the movie seats watching a movie and a power just and all. So we just said, we closed the doors and said, hey, we're temporarily closed. That temporary turned into permanency. And if I were to be honest, that kind of stifled our hopes and dreams. It stifled our ability to dream big again. Or if we dream big, it slowed us down in terms of communicating that publicly. Because we didn't want to look like Boo Boo the Fool again. Because we were saying, God did this. God did this. God wanted us to do this. And God, this is all to God's glory. We were saying the right things. We were giving back to the church. We were doing things in the community. We weren't doing things wrong. But the doors closed anyway. And so how do you now deal with the challenges and the obstacles that come your way? How do you see something before you, but now you have these obstacles and you want to press, you want to fight through, but you remember the last time.
Oh.
You remember the last time you stepped out on faith. And now you gun shy. You don't want to reach out again. You don't want to dream big, because now when you dream big, now you might fail. And if you fail, now you're questioning God. Like, God, where are you in this? God, why would you do this to me? Why would you make me look stupid like this? All I was doing was what I thought you were telling me to do. But yet we still have to do what Paul said. Paul said to forget the things that are behind. Forget the disappointment. Forget the failed dreams. Forget the challenges that you had that didn't turn out the way that you thought that they should. Forget that. And I know it's hard. I know it's tough.
Oh, Jesus.
It's not easy to overcome that, but that's why Paul said you got to be mature. Because that maturity will allow you then to renew your mind, right? To forget those things that's behind you and to reach again, to dream again. I'm here to tell you, y'all, it's time to dream. And it's time to believe God again. Don't give up. Don't be gun shy. God wants you. God, I'm telling you, y'all don't know how much God is a chilling for you. He's rooting you on. He wants you to be all that you can be. He wants you to be your best self.
Amen.
He wants you to be what he created you to be. But you can't be what he created you to be if you continue to remember what's back here. He won't be who he's called you to be if you continue to remember the failures, the challenges, the lost hopes and dreams. He wants you to do these amazing things. So as we're in this last day of 2017, my one message for you today, and next week I'll be picking up the last two, the reaching and the pressing. We'll talk about that next week, this two parts. But today all I want you to do is just forget.
Yeah.
Just forget. You can't reach if you stay to remember. You can't reach forward if you keep reaching back. See, you're like this, and you can't go anywhere if you still do like this. And you're not moving. If you try to reach in, but you're like, no, I keep remembering that. You can't move. So today, y'all, in 2017, let this be the day. Let this be the day that we forget. That we forget the challenges and the obstacles. Let this be the day that we forget the things that have been holding us back. And then, next week, we're going to talk about reaching. Because we want you to reach for what God has for you. We want you to reach for those things. And that's why this is a year of transformation. When you begin to forgive, and then you begin to reach, and you press and you're reaching, and then once you do that, that's when transformation happens in your life. So that's the takeaway. That's the message. That's the big idea. Let's forget. Forgetting those things which are behind. And as Paul was teaching in this letter, he nothing without Christ. So today, if you want to have this year of transformation, y'all, it starts with Christ. Because see, the renewing of your mind is the renewed focus on Christ. It's not for you to get smarter or get more intellectual or get more academic. No, it's a renewed, it's a focus on Christ. So today we want to offer Christ to you. If you never accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior, this is the day that you can accept Christ. Wouldn't it be amazing, y'all, to leave out 2017 strong? To leave out strong. So we're going to offer Christ to you. We're going to offer.